जय गुरुदेव चिल्ड्रन एंड गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीबडी ऑफ यू. इन टुडेज क्लास वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज होल नंबर्स एंड नेचुरल नंबर्स. एंड होल नंबर्स एंड नेचुरल नंबर्स ऑल्सो बेटा यू हैव लर्न इन क्लास फिफ्थ ऑल्सो. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट मीन्स बिगेस्ट नंबर, स्मॉलेस्ट नंबर, प्रेडिसेसर, सक्सेसर एंड ऑल दिस today. But before that, first of all, I would like to give you the definitions. What are the natural numbers and what are the whole numbers? See that on the blackboard now. First of all, natural numbers. Counting numbers. Starting from one is called natural number. For example, see that set of natural numbers. How we will write that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on up to infinity. This is known as the set of these numbers is known as the natural number. See one more time, counting numbers, starting with general counting as we are using the. Suppose we are saying how many students are in your class. At the time you are starting counting like 1, 2, 3 and so on. It means which number system we are using at that time? We are using natural numbers. Now, second, see that whole numbers. A set of natural numbers. Including with zero is called or is known as whole number. That means example I said that a set of natural number including with zero means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on. Okay, and like that. These are natural numbers. If we include 0 also along with this, these numbers will become whole numbers. Okay? Means counting numbers starting from 1 are known as natural numbers. And if along with the natural numbers we include 0, then these numbers will become the set of whole numbers. Next thing in this topic is predecessor and successor. Predecessor means beta, suppose you have given any number. Suppose for example, I am taking any number 5 you have given. Okay. Now he is saying that find predecessor and successor of the number 5. What you will do? Predecessor means number minus 1. Whatever number you have to given. In here we have given 5. 5 minus 1. That is 4. Will be predecessor. Okay. And successor. Is equal to number plus 1. Okay. That is 5 plus 1. Is equal to 6. Will be successor. It means. Predecessor means you will exactly whatever number you have to given, you will subtract 1 from that given number, it will become the predecessor. And for successor, what you will do? Given number plus 1 is known as the successor. This also you have learned in the class 5th. Okay, now we are going to start exercise 2.1. Exercise 2.1 now. See that question number 1. Okay, write the next 3 natural numbers after 2099. Means you have to write 3 natural number after this. What you will do? First number. First natural number. What it will be? 2099 plus 1. It will be 2100. Then second number will be 2 plus 1. It will be 2101. Okay, third number will be 2101 plus 1 is equal to 2100. Just simple, nothing is difficult in this, or these kind of questions already you have done in previous class, so nothing is difficult in this exercise also. Okay, now we are moving to question number 2. See that, what is question number 2? Write 3 whole numbers occurring just before, okay, just after I have find, okay, for just before, what you will do? Just before of number 10001, what you will do? As I have added 1 into each number, what you will do? Subtract 1 from the given number and continue the process. In this way, you will do. This question will be your homework question. I am not doing this. As I have added, just now you will subtract 1 from this number, then whatever result means, it is how much? 10,000. Then 10,000 will come, then you will subtract again 1 from then 10,000, it will become 9,999. Then again you will subtract 1 from the given number, it will become 9,999 minus 1, it will become 9,998. In this way, you will continue this question yourself. Now we are moving to the next question. Number 3rd now. We have given the number and we have to find successor. As you successor of the given number, what we will do? 1 2 0 0 9 9. What you will do for the successor? I told you, you will add 1 to the given number plus 1. It will become 1 successor. This will be your answer. In this way, rest of the part of this question you will do yourself. Now question number 4. Okay, nothing you have to do. You will add 1 to the given number. It will become your successor. Okay, then we are moving. Find the predecessor of the number 799. Okay, for predecessor, what we have to do? We will subtract 1 from the given number. Okay, predecessor means exactly 1 number before that. Successor means exactly 1 number after the given number. Then subtract minus 1 from this. It will become predecessor. 9 minus 1, 8, then 9, 7. It will be your answer. Okay, in this way, in this question also, you have to given many more parts. You will perform those parts yourself. Now see that question number 5th. Which number is the predecessor of the largest 5 digit number? Okay, question number 5th. See that now. Question number 5th. Okay,
विच नंबर इज द प्रेडिसेसर ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट फाइव डिजिट नंबर. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल एवरीबॉडी ऑफ यू नो दैट लार्जेस्ट वन डिजिट नंबर इज 9, टू डिजिट नंबर इज 99, थ्री डिजिट नंबर इज 999, फोर डिजिट 9999, फाइव डिजिट विल बी 99999. ओके, इन दिस वे वी कैन कंटिन्यू अप टू हाउ मेनी डिजिट ही इज आस्किंग फ्रॉम अस. नाउ जस्ट सी लार्जेस्ट फाइव डिजिट नंबर इज इक्वल टू नाइन 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 नाइन, वन टू थ्री फोर फाइव. ओके, नाउ व्हाट ही इज आस्किंग, विच नंबर इज द प्रेडिसेसर ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट फाइव डिजिट नंबर. ओके, विच नंबर इज द प्रेडिसेसर ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट फाइव. यू हैव टू फाइंड द प्रेडिसेसर ऑफ दिस फाइव डिजिट नंबर. व्हाट यू विल डू फॉर प्रेडिसेसर, यू जस्ट सबट्रैक्ट माइनस वन फ्रॉम दिस. नाइन माइनस वन एट, देन नाइन 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 नाइन, दिस विल बी योर आंसर. ओके, ही इज आस्किंग दैट विच नंबर इज द प्रेडिसेसर ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट फाइव डिजिट नंबर. यू जस्ट राइट लार्जेस्ट फाइव डिजिट नंबर एंड देन फाइंड द प्रेडिसेसर बाय सब्ट्रैक्टिंग वन फ्रॉम द गिवन नंबर. इन दिस वे यू विल गेट योर आंसर. सी दैट नाउ क्वेश्चन नंबर सिक्स. कंसिडर द नंबर 73456. ओके, 73456, दिस इज गिवन नंबर. यूजिंग द डिजिट ऑफ दिस नंबर राइट थ्री नंबर्स ग्रेटर देन इट. ओके, वी कैन राइट थ्री नंबर्स ग्रेटर देन इट. राइट दैट 73654 73654 73546, like that I have written. Okay, now what he is asking, arrange them in ascending order. Ascending order means arrange them in ascending order. Ascending order means from smaller to greater. Smaller to greater. Now select which one is the smallest number in this. 73546. This will come first. 73546. Then second number 73564 and lastly 73654. In this way you can arrange them in ascending order. Okay, now next question is, make the greatest and the smallest three digit number by using the digit 3, 9 and 7. Okay, 3, 9 and 7, we have three different digits. We have to make the greatest number by these. For the greatest number, what you will do, arrange the number in descending order. Okay, means greater to smaller. Write that greater 9, then 7, then 3. It will be your greatest number. Okay, and for smallest number, what you will do? Smallest number, what you will do? Arrange them in descending order. Arrange them in ascending order. Okay, greater to smaller. Now write them smaller to greater. See that now. Smaller means firstly write first number, then 7. And then 9. This way, this will be your smallest number. It is so simple, nothing you have to do. So, already these are the, this is like a means division type of the previous whatever you have learned in the last classes. Okay, Just see, 397 was given to us and he is asking that make the greatest number and smallest number by using these digits. What we have done? First of all, for the greatest number, what we have done? Arrange the number in means from greater to smaller, or you can say in descending order. Then 9 is the greatest number, then after that 7 will come and then 3 will come. Okay, and for the next smallest number, what you will do? You will arrange the number in ascending order. Means firstly smallest will return, then second smallest, and then lastly the greatest. Okay, in this way you can do the question number 7 also. Now see that question number 8. Question number 8 is how many whole numbers are there between 35 and 47? 35 to 47. Okay, what you will do? You will write the numbers between 35 and 47 and you will count them. Okay, like 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45 and 46. You will write them here and then you will count them, and after counting whatever will come, that will be your answer. Okay, so this question you will perform in your homework. Understood? Now come to the question number 9. What is that question? What is the successor of the predecessor of 799? Okay. What is the successor of the predecessor of 799? Just try to understand. What is the successor of the predecessor of 799? You have number given. Given number is 799. Now, first of all, what he is asking? First of all, you have to nine predecessor of this number. Predecessor of this number will be 799 minus 1. It will become 798. Now, you have to find successor of this number. What you will do again? Add. Nothing is that. 799 will be your answer. Now, maybe you have understood. You have given number 799. Then what he is asking, what will be the predecessor, what will be the successor of predecessor of this number? So first of all, what you will do? Find the predecessor of this number. It will come 798. Then again find successor of this number. It will come 799. Okay. So in this way, you can see that till question number 9, we have completed. Okay. Question number 10 is that give the predecessor of the following. You have given the number and you have to find predecessor of that number, and what you will do? You will subtract 1 from each number and whatever result will come, that will be your answer. So I am not going to do that. You will perform that question yourself. So in this way, question number 10 will be your homework. Now come to the question number 11, beta. Okay, what is that question number 11? Give the smallest 6 digit number ending in 7. Okay. First of all, beta, see that the smallest 2-digit number. Do you know, nah? Everybody of you know. What is the smallest 2-digit number? That is 10. Okay. Then the smallest 3-digit number. 3-digit number will be 100. The smallest 4-digit number will be 1000. The smallest 5-digit number will be 10,000. Okay. The smallest 6-digit number will be 1 lakh. The smallest 7-digit will be 10 lakh. Okay. In this way, you can see that he is asking us give the smallest 6-digit number ending in 7. See that the smallest 6-digit number is write 1 and after that write 50 in front of that number. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now he is saying that smallest 5-digit number ending with ending with 7. So what you will do, ending with 7 means unit place, you need 7. So write 7 here. Rest of the digit will remain same. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 1. This will be your answer. Have you understood in this way? The question can be asked, write the smallest 6 digit number ending in digit 8, ending in digit 5, ending in digit 4. So in this way you can do this question also. But many more questions can be asked on the basis of this question. Now come to the question number 12 beta. Give the largest 6 digit number ending in 8. Okay. One question I am doing. Largest 6 digit number. First of all, you just largest 6 digit number. It will be 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Now, largest 6 digit number ending in 8. What you will do? Nothing else. As we have done here, you just change the unit place by 8. Okay. And rest of the digit will remain same. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This will be your answer. On the basis of this question also, many more questions can be formed. Like the, write the greatest 6 digit or 5 digit or 8 digit number ending in digit 8 or ending in digit 7 or ending in digit 5. Many more questions can be formed. It is not necessary that always this question will come. You have to understand what is the concept behind the question and how you have to perform that question. Okay. So it depends on your personal practice also, and you have done these questions previously also. So these questions are not new for you. Okay. Now come to the question number 13. Is the smallest natural number greater than the smallest whole number? Just see, what is the question? Question number 13 is, smallest, I am writing it here on, just see. Question number 13. Is smallest natural number? First of all, you just write smallest natural number. Smallest natural number. Just now, when I have started the class, at that time I have given you definition of natural numbers and whole numbers. And I told you that the numbers starting from 1 are known as the natural numbers. It means smallest natural number will be 1. And you already know smallest whole number will be 0, because whole numbers are always starting from 0. Now see that what he is asking is the smallest natural number. This is the smallest natural number 1. Okay. And smallest natural number greater than the smallest whole number. The smallest whole number is 0. You can see that 1 is greater than 0 now. 1 is greater than 0. And what is that? This natural number. Or this is natural number is smallest natural number is greater than smallest whole number. So what is he is asking, whether this statement is yes or no. Yes, it is yes. Maybe have you understood? SN means smallest natural number. SW means smallest whole number. Smallest natural number means 1 will be greater than 0. I have written above. So statement will be yes. Now come to the question number next. Now see that question number 14. Okay. What he is asking, that what is the predecessor of the successor of 278? Just try to understand. This is same as the question number, which one I have done? Question number 9. Same as question number 9. So you will try to do this question. I am just making you understand how you will do this question. What is the predecessor of the successor of 278? See that 278 is the given number. What will be its successor?
its successor will be 279. Then again he is asking, find its predecessor. Predecessor means minus 1. 279 minus 1, what will come? 278. So you will perform this question yourself. I orally told you how you will perform. First of all, you will find the successor of this number, and then again you will find the predecessor of whatever result will come, that predecessor you will find. In this way, beta, you will complete this question number 14 yourself, and still other simply nobody should have any problem in this question because it's a simple question. Or now come to the question number 15, that is the last question of this exercise. Which is the predecessor and successor of the largest 5-digit number? You can see that on board I have written, previously I have written largest 5-digit number. It will be 99999. Okay, now what he is saying, that find the predecessor and successor of this 5-digit number. So you will do this question also yourself. Now many questions based on the predecessor and successor I have done. Now question number 15, beta, you will do yourself. This will be also your homework. So question number 14, question number 15, question number 10 and 1, and some part of the question number 3rd and 4th I have given in your homework. So you will perform these questions yourself. So what we have learned today in this topic, whole numbers and natural number, first of all I teach you what was the definition of natural number, the counting number starting from 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There is no limit, means which one will be the greatest natural numbers. There is no limit for that. Okay, so these numbers are known as the natural number. Okay, then next we have learned that whole numbers. Whole numbers means numbers, counting numbers including with zero. If along with the counting number we include zero, means we will start like that 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. The set of these numbers is known as the whole numbers. Okay. And there is also no limit for the greatest whole number. Okay. Then after I taught you how to find the predecessor and successor of any given number. For predecessor, what you will do? Predecessor, you will subtract 1 from the given number. And for successor, you will add 1 in the what given number. Whatever in your question is given in that number, if you will subtract 1 from the number, you will get predecessor. And if you will add 1 to the given number, you will subtracting 1, you will get predecessor, or adding 1, you will get successor of that number. In this way, and after that I have we have done here many, means your exercise 2.1, and in this way we have completed exercise 2.1, and you will also complete. And if you will have doubt, you can send me to my personal WhatsApp number by writing your question, so that I can talk to you and I can remove your doubt. Okay, we can discuss on your doubts also in the next class. Just enough for today. Thank you, and Jai Gurudev to all of you.